He's like top five on net play ladder right now.
He was top one for a while. Okay, we're getting into it. We're getting into it.
All right, what do you think about Foxidos? You play this way more than I do, I think.
Dude, Foxidos is all about who can tech chase better. That's what I see it.
Okay.
And Hax is the best tech chaser on Earth. Look at that.
As he messes up, but that
one he got before was really hard.
Yeah. Hax's method of tech chasing is like really, really crazy. He just kind of like knocked them down and then like use like wave shine down to cover something and then he'll like down air another side.
Mm-hmm.
And if someone techs behind him, he'll like do running grab on that or something.
Yeah, it's actually crazy. Yeah. And did you see the one time Smokey got a knockdown? He got get up attack. Mm. Can't ever get up attack. That's bad.
Right. Right.
Yeah. So like. But Hax, like, see, he's going to get a shine here because he literally, it's crazy. He doesn't stop.
And his down air pressure is probably the best down air pressure I've ever
played. He's the only one that gets down air safely. Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Normally it's supposed to be -7 and most people get it -8 or worse.
Yeah. But Hax is the only one that gets the, because to get it the -7, it has to be you land the frame after the last hit. It's really hard. You have to get like a perfect fast fall.
Right.
And you can only hit with like a certain number of hits. There's a Reddit post on it.
Right. But
see how Hax gets so much off of these shine tech chases? It's crazy.
Yeah. No one usually I think one of the common things, it was more back in the day, but still like prevalent today, that like a lot of people say like, oh, tech chasing with Fox is not that good because of shine and it's like not reactable.
Yeah.
But Hax is really proving that like that's really not the case. Like he can really do it.
Yeah, yeah. Hax like pushes the limits of every character he plays. With Fox like reaction tech chasing with shine, with Falcon just like everything, Hax dashing.
Yeah. Oh, he tried to do double shine turnaround grab.
Yeah, stuck his pressure.
Ooh,
okay, Mr. Wavelength is dead.
Right now, there's a huge, huge deficit. And I actually disagree with the notion of people saying, like, oh, Foxidos are volatile. Like, I mean, like, yes, you can make the comeback, but, like, if you're getting out playing Foxidos, it's really hard to find a way in, you know?
Yeah, I definitely think that being up in Foxidos, like, having to approach your opponent, it makes it so much harder. Because then, like, your opponent can literally just, like, dash dance, and they never have to approach you.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah, you can laser, but they can laser too. So, like, effectively, lasering is trading damage. And if you're down, you don't want to do that.
Did you see what he did there? He did, like, he did shine, wave dash forward into turnaround grab to cover the tech in place. It was really good.
Damn. And you see after that, when he did, from the ledge, auto cancel, fastball bear, dash grab, Smokey side be under it. Hax does some nutty stuff.
His option coverage is out of this world.
Yeah, it's just like, he covers an it's like, I think that's like the soul of East Coast style. Just cover an option, on reaction, cover the next option.
Yeah.
On reaction, cover an option. That's why Mewtwo King's so good versus Peach, right? Because that's the whole matchup. You just on reaction, cover an option over and over and over again.
Yeah. Ooh, that's the first up smash I've really seen from Hax. He usually doesn't go for that, but I think he's recognizing like the change in the meta. Something that up smash has that other things don't is that it like launches so early.
Yeah.
You know?
See Hax and short hop bear to cover one side B timing, short hop bear again to cover another side B timing.
Yeah.
Wait, what'd you say about up smash washing?
I think these days in the meta, ending combos or starting combos and ending combos with up smash is really good because it pops them up really early and there's no chance for ASDI down, which is something that's really prevalent.
Yeah, I think it used to be that like when people didn't when people didn't ASDI down as much, you just wanted to get short hop up airs or up tilts.
Right.
But now that everyone ASDI is down, up smash is like back in.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
It's so interesting how like this changes. Especially since everyone just like, DI is down in a way, just SDIs, okay. See, like, Hax missed the reaction, but like, that F smash was almost just perfect option coverage.
Right. Ooh, yeah, honestly, I think what you
reaction
said
tech chase off of shine
is like really true. I think Smokey's just really getting out tech chase. Every time he gets a knockdown, like, it feels like nothing's happening.
Yeah, but every time Hax gets a knockdown,
see, like,
it's
right
huge.
There.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And the way Hax DI's things is so good.
See, again, like another knockdown. Because Hax did ASDI.
Yeah. Like, Smokey's won, like, 4 neutral interactions right now.
Yeah. Smokey literally keeps getting, like, good knockdowns, and then he just doesn't get the punish.
Right.
I actually think Smokey has always been, like, a really patient player. I think Fox players often get stereotyped as like, oh, this guy's a tech skill monster. Like, yeah, Smokey has incredible tech skill.
Yeah.
But, like, I actually think his, like, best matchups are, like, Sheik and Puff.
Yeah, I super agree.
Yeah. Even though, obviously, I think if you asked him, he'd be like, no, I'm the best at the Fox, you know, I just played bad.
Ooh.
Oh, nice.
Are you starting to make a comeback?
That was a great dash dance. Oh, my God.
Wow.
He just got like 5 tech chases. He didn't get like the very last one, but still.
And it's like, what he does is like, once he misses a tech chase, he'll just like dash dance in an advantageous position and either mix it up between like continue to dash dance or run up drill or nair with really, really good fade back.
Yeah. Yeah, like Hax is amazing at getting resets. Like that's what, because he's our, he actually, for anyone who doesn't know, Hax used to be pretty good in Marvel, in Marvel 3.
Oh, really?
Yeah, at next level tournaments, he would enter Melee and Marvel 3. Because Marvel, it's Marvel's just a labber game. You literally just lab and then you do 0 to deaths. Mm. Like that's exactly how Hax plays.
Right.
And like Hax, so in Marvel, there's this thing called resets where like, you some characters, you can like 0 to death off of one hit, but some characters, you hit them, and then you have to like, win another like a advantageous neutral reaction in the middle of your punish,
right,
to get the second combo that kills them. And so Hax is really good at knowing like when to back off.
And also, I feel like Smokey really isn't DI'ing things as well. In fact, when he gets hit, he always gets popped up. I don't think he's holding down enough after getting hit by stuff.
That's true. Yeah, his counterplay could be better. I want. Oh my god!
Damn.
Oh my god! That was amazing. That was insane. He just kept going. I kept thinking it would end.
And that wasn't even off a tech chase, which is what we're like talking about, like hitting his strength. Like he shows that like it's
what,
not just
what
that.
Was that off? What was the grab? Oh,
I think it was like up to.
Jeez. Oh, damn. See, like literally, if Hax got that ledge dash air, he would have gone a full jump up air.
Right.
He just covers everything.
Okay. Good.
Like systematically. Yeah. And then, but Hax just gets a smash DI.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
He didn't get the deep part of up air, to be fair.
Yeah, that's true. It's harder to smash DI up air if you hit closer with it, for anyone who doesn't know.
Yeah. I don't like that up smash.
Yeah, because it's like it's
you
a hard read.
One in three.
You don't need to hard read there. Like you can react to tech chase there.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, yeah. This is kind of a body bag.
Yeah,
wait, this is not 2-0. Isn't this
1-0? No, it's 2-0.
Wow.
It was 2 Battlefield moves.
Wow, that went quickly. Oh, and
I like that you realize that you have to tech chase on the low percent up throws.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think you have to. I think the reaction is just really hard.
Yeah.
You don't have to, but it's like easier to get that than to get like the pure reaction.
Or no, I think you do have to react because if they DI away, I don't think it's a true follow-up at 0.
I actually don't know. It's very possible it's not. There was some weird stuff like with Marth.
Oh, you know what it might be?
Yeah.
It might be that he up threw him by the platform and it's hard to react to where he went on the platform and
Yes.
away, right?
Yeah, that's